welcome the next group, We Chill, with Lauren Zaplinskis, Cassandra Musto, Casey Keeley, and Carrie Catala.
This is just to say. She saw you look at her, you know, at the party the other night. Only out the corner of her eye did she see your gaze trail towards her pretty boy eyes paying petty attention to hers. But she kept her focus on whatever it was she was doing. She didn't make any grand attempt to gawk back. She ignored you on purpose. And she heard you say hi and call her name, but pretended she didn't. She pulled out her phone as if there was an urgent message that immediately required a serious response. But out the corner of her eye, she saw your focus fall and your eyes droop down to your own phone. And for the millisecond of attention she actually did let herself pay towards you, she saw a pitifully pathetic micro-expression consume your face while you distractedly responded to an urgent message that immediately required a serious response. You probably think she hates you now. But it's okay. It's been a while, and it's true she thinks, but at the same time, it's not. As much as she wants you to feel as bad and lost and abandoned as you made her feel when you turned your back to her and left her in your shadow, as terribly as she longs for the bones in your chest to break so maybe someday your heart will be vulnerable enough to collapse too. She'd much rather walk up to you and ask you if you could go outside to talk and clear things up. So she could tell you she misses you and somehow put into words how every time she sees you, she still gets that achy, swollen knot in her throat that seems to puff up by instinct, like her body's own defense against letting what she thinks become what she says. So maybe she can protect herself from getting infected by whatever lovesick germs you must have accidentally inflicted her with. She would love to be friends. But this vaccination hasn't worn off just yet, and this doctor's mask the past inspired her to put on wouldn't be smart to remove right now. She wants to, but she shouldn't, so she doesn't, and she pulls out her phone.
Judges' scores are 8.5, 8, 8.5, 9, 8.5, and 9.5.
Forgive me, for I have sinned. I carry the guilt in my black backpack, along with all the unfinished projects, ideas, goals, zipper hardly binding together what I have left untouched and unaccomplished. I carry the remorse in my bones. It weighs down my youthful limbs, stunting the growth in my legs, arms, neck, hands. Potential energy left idling like the motor of a car. Destination unknown and indefinable. Circuit unplugged and rewired through a loophole in my very own brain. Eventually left disconnected and dormant in the lonely gravel driveway. I carry the dissatisfaction in my lungs, and I feel its pang every time I inhale the clean air deeply. Each breath reminds me of the next one, and I effortlessly lose touch with my surroundings. While insomnia and sleep are each deadly, I spiral downwards into both. While my backpack lies waiting on my glimmering wood floor, I lie engulfed in the sea of my comforter, the speed of my car that carries me away from controversy, the music of my mind's unknown directions. While I reside in lazy indecisiveness, life is waiting outside my doorstep. Goals are patiently lingering at the tips of my limp fingers and the soles of my heavy feet. I've allowed them to remain stagnant for much too long. Forgive me, for I've sinned. I will carry the guilt no longer.
Judges' scores are 8, 8, 8, 9, 9, and 8.5. Casual.
Okay, I see you. I see you. Okay.
What's that?
All right, here we go.
This is called enlightenment.
We are together.
We heal for the better.
We exist forever.
And we love boundlessly.
Soundlessly feeling heartache for not ourselves, but for another's cancer, toothache, or loss. Because there is an invisible connection that is not one of selection, but a stream of affection through our own introspection.
We are together, and not just Earth's great people, but one silverback gorilla, one Himalayan mountain, and one bean of vanilla. One sunset over the tree, one chicken egg, and one fig tree.
We are together. No matter how far I will roam, I will never be alone.
Because I am related to every single heart that beats here.
And there.
And there.
And there.
And everywhere.
You can find me because I am one with our family tree. The one that is related to the tree is me.
And you.
And everyone.
And everything.
Every particle of dust and every herd of birds flying over and pooping on our heads is just them saying hello.
Because we are together.
We are here to appreciate our grassy, watery, muddy planet full of life, offering more than happiness, more than violence, money and mean words. Love is what we are to excrete to every man you see on the street and to the field of wheat.
Because there is nothing better than being together, and we are. But we dress to impress each other. We talk endlessly about things insignificant. We always want to win.
Be more.
Be the one everyone else is jealous of.
But we are all together.
So why do we do so many negatives when we can relax in our natural sedatives? Because everything and everyone are relatives.
But we yell
and scream, point and gossip.
But what is the need?
Our true nature is to love a stranger, but oh, the danger.
Stop.
Open all your eyelids, widen your cracked lips and pale winter cheeks. Let every good deed you see become one with your loving heart that is alive with the yellow skies and deep rivers.
With gray and colorful fish, mosquitoes and swans, because we affect dusks and dawns with our smiles and cries. Trembling, we will walk with realizing laughs and ride on whitewater rafts. We will believe in the central connection that has brought everything alive at peace.
When we are all together.
Judges' scores are 9.5, 9.5, 9.5, 9.5, 9.5, 10.